Hi, this is Raj from Gizmotan, and today we're going to talk about 15 things you should do once you buy the OnePlus 6. These are tips, tricks, features that OnePlus has on the phones that you should absolutely use. Let's jump right in and talk about the alert slider. After constant feedback from the OnePlus community, OnePlus has finally incorporated the alert slider to move to the silent, vibrate, and ringer mode, instead of using the Android priority mode in the previous devices. The alert slider is also moved to the right, which helps you toggle using your thumb. Under the settings, make sure you have enabled vibrate on ring mode. Have alarms enabled for both vibrate and silent mode, because you don't want to miss your alarms. And also mute the media on the silent mode. Call recording. I'm sure this can be very useful. It isn't enabled by default and you have to go into your phone caller settings and enable it. If you would like to record automatically or manually take action, I would recommend keeping it at manual so you would see an icon when you're on a call. Or else you can set to automatically record calls as well, which I don't think would make sense. You have the option to record only for favorite contacts or specific contacts. The other option you have is for all unknown callers as well. This can come in very handy. Rounded corners. This is an app that you have to download. Rounded corners allows you to convert your non-symmetrical edges on the OnePlus 6 when you hide the notch to symmetrical ones. Once you enable the Rounded Corners app, this makes the phone look symmetrical and is more like the Galaxy S9. And I think this is how it should have been when you hide the notch. You have the option to choose the opacity or even how rounded you want the corners to be. I set it to about 60 to 65. I think that is the correct setting. Let me know if you think otherwise. It gives a few other options if you buy the paid version of the app, like notification light on the edges. However, if you want to just make the corners round, the free app suffices. Also, make sure you go into the battery settings and set the app to don't optimize under the battery optimization option. Otherwise, the app shuts down after a while. Navigation buttons and gestures. OnePlus has added the feature for gestures instead of using navigation buttons. I use it currently. You swipe up from the center and hold it for a second to go into your recent apps drawer. Swipe up from the center to go to the home screen. Swipe up from the left or the right to go back. There is some getting used to this, but you will not go back to buttons after using this. You can also check my other video where I talk about why this can help avoid the AMOLED burn-in problem. The other option you have is to enable hideable navigation buttons. You could use this in case you don't want to go to gestures. You have the option to toggle if you want to toggle it or hide it. It will be visible on the home screen and the app drawer by default, but you can toggle it for apps. Again, use this instead of using the fixed buttons to protect your AMOLED screen. Let's say if you use buttons instead of gestures, you have the option to take actions based on that. You have the long press or double tap to take an action. For example, long press on the home button and Google Assistant pops up. You can have similar setup to lock your screen when you double tap on the home button. You can't use this while using the navigation gestures. Lock screen and other gestures. This has been a part of Oxygen OS feature for a while. What I personally love is the long screenshot feature. You enable 3-swipe screenshot and then click on the button at the bottom so it automatically takes a longer screenshot. You then have the option to edit the screenshot and so on. You can do the same action with volume down and power button as well. The other gesture options for lock screen are the same as before. You can assign different functions with different characters when the screen is off. I use V for flashlight and draw M to navigation to work. It comes in very handy when I just sit in the car and swipe M. Parallapse, it allows you to have multiple social media and messenger apps. It's not a special feature, but if you want to have multiple apps that you use or you use dual SIM, you can just use this without downloading an additional app on the phone to get this functionality. Google Play Protect. Enable this if it is disabled. This is a feature that Google added recently so it scans your device for malicious apps. It will flag if you have any app that could harm the device. Smart Unlock or OK Google detection. This is important if you want to have a pure hands-free experience with Google Assistant, or else it won't unlock your device. For example, when I use my Bullets V2 earphones and long press on the pause button, it doesn't unlock my device if it doesn't recognize my voice. So set up your voice and enable this feature. You have the other smart unlock features as well, like places and devices. Check those out. Face unlock in darker lighting conditions. This is similar to the selfie flash options you have on the iPhone. It lights up the device during low light conditions, so it detects your face. Works really well. App locker under security and lock screen allows you to lock certain apps. Let's say you don't want people to go into your gallery or WhatsApp and so on, you can lock them using your fingerprint. OTG support. OnePlus has the feature where you'll have to enable once you connect your OTG device and it'll go off in the next 10 minutes. You can get the options under advanced settings. Under advanced settings, you also have the gaming mode. This is one of the features that they've improved from the previous generation gaming mode settings. When you have this enabled, you will not get banner notifications, so it doesn't intrude while gaming. Battery saver, in case you want to save juice on your phone but still want to play games like PUBG, you can enable battery saver to limit your FPS or resolution of the screen. This can help you get a little more battery life. Network boost. If you're playing games like PUBG, where network speed is crucial, it's important that you have this enabled. The phone will limit the bandwidth of other apps and push all resources to the game. This helps reduce latency. I keep PUBG and YouTube on this list because I use those apps a lot. You can add any apps into that list. So it's not limited to gaming apps only. This makes the OnePlus 6 one of the most powerful gaming devices. Long press on the home screen and you will see a few options to customize your home screen. You have the double tap to lock when you're on the home screen. It is disabled by default and you would want to enable that. The icon pack is a pretty cool way to customize your phone as well. You apply a wallpaper and then choose a custom icon set to go with the wallpaper. So personalize your phone. Shelf allows you to do the usual stuff, add widgets, write a memo, and add it to the reminder. You also have the recent apps and recent contacts widget. Categorize your messages. OnePlus SMS app allows you to categorize messages into their spam or not spam folder. In case you get a lot of spam messages, you can enable this. I personally use the Microsoft SMS Organizer app. It's the best in the business according to me. I will do a detailed review on it soon. Status bar. Choose the icon for battery indicator. The battery percentage is added in the 5.1.6 update, but the 5.1.6 update is currently rolled back. So it's currently not available for everyone out there. However, with the status bar icons, you want to choose the least amount because you have the notch already. So disable the ones you don't want to see on the screen on top. One pro tip, start using the pro mode on your OnePlus 6 camera. The photos are much better when you click them in pro mode. I will be making a detailed video on this in the future, but for starters, keep the ISO to as low as possible and increase the shutter speed to get more light into the camera, in turn less grainy images. One thing you need to be careful about is if you keep the shutter speed too high, you might not be able to keep the phone steady for, let's say, 1 second or two. One other thing that you can do as well is buy a gimbal, which helps you take photos in pro mode with longer shutter speeds. So start playing around with this. I'm sure you will never go back to clicking on auto mode. That's it from my end. Thank you for watching and do let me know if you have any other tips or tricks in the comment section below. Subscribe to the channel and share this video with the OnePlus 6 users.